I'm Rashid Young. I'm originally from Hollis, Queens, New York. Some people know me from
Ron's house.
Who's house? Ron's house.
Some of you know me as your sneaky guru's favorite goo. While others still know me as the fruit consigliere. But now I decided to mash up sneakies, food, and add a little laughter. We talking foot long. I decided to take my talents and my resources and push it together. We're talking athletes, celebs, chefs, and you know what? They're all my friends. Come on, boy.
Welcome, another edition of Soul Food Kicks and Giggles. I'm your host, Rashid Young, and today is the real soul food. We're going to Georgia's East Side Barbecue here on Low East Side. Yes, I can't wait. I'm hungry. Ribs, mac and cheese, kicks, crispy dial, A-Life. Let's do it. Come on.
Hey, Kennedy, look. Here comes Rashid.
Yo. Chris, what's good,
hey,
man?
What's up, Rashid? What's going on,
Chilling,
man?
You know?
You want to meet my little guy, Kennedy?
Kennedy, what's
hi,
good?
Buddy.
Hey, buddy.
Yeah, so this Georgia's East Side Barbecue I've been telling you about.
Awesome.
Best banana pudding in the Lower East Side.
Oh, man. Yep. I'm psyched.
You got to try
Let's
it.
Get in there. Give our audience a little history on who you are and what you do.
I currently manage a retail location for one of the premier brands from New York City known as A-Life. Mm-hmm. A-Life is a lifestyle brand representing New York since 1999. Born and bred out of New York City street culture, art culture, just everything that happens from day to day.
So tell us how you got involved with the sneaker world.
I think sneakers is always part of like your outfit, your uniform. Growing up in Brooklyn, it was kind of like a competition between everyone. So it started like in fifth grade for me with Pumas, Le Tigres, Lee jeans, and it just kept on going and going. Went from Pumas to Avias to Alessis or Elise to Spot Bills to Sauconys or Sauconys, Diodoras. And then when Michael Jordan ruled the court in 1985 and he became that guy, it was all about the Jordans.
Give me a story with one of the pairs that you kicked that sounds like absolutely f***ing crazy.
I sold a pair of Dunk Highs for $8,500 before.
What are you saying? Come on, man, are you playing?
What'd you do with the money?
Everything I could. I went to St. Martin for like a week with my lady and,
right.
You know, just had a good time. Bought more shoes, really.
So what's your favorite pair of kicks then?
I would probably say that the pair that I treasure the most would probably be the 1985 Air Jordan 1.
Now, do you keep it in a safe?
No, I have a couple storage rooms, you know.
Couple of storage rooms.
Yeah, I've been up to like 2,000 pairs of shoes.
I don't even have 20 pairs of sneakers.
Nah, you probably have in rotation, right? I just wear a couple. I wear these Pumas designed by A-Life.
Okay.
I kind of like represent the store. I like to wear them as much as possible so they look worn and people can see that, you know, we don't just treasure them, we wear them to wear them out. But this shoe's kind of awesome. It represents the A-Life store because when you first walk in, there's these huge mirrors on the right-hand side.
Right.
And you have this white tile, mm-hmm. the white midsole, and then the bottom is a gum sole because growing up like in New York City, the gum sole on kicks was like a staple for New York sneakerheads. It was like something that was mostly coveted, that you were like, yo, I need gum bottom Air Force Ones, or I need some gum bottom, you know, Dunk Highs, or whatever shoe it was that you wore that you were particular about, the gum bottom just made it that much better.
There's a lot of gum. We're really young though.
I think it's really cool when you meet someone else that's into shoes, you know, because you share stories, you know. And it's kind of like food, you know, because food brings people together.
That's right.
You know, that's why I love this place. You know, it's kind of like a little family spot
right.
that you don't belong to, you know, but you're there.
Alan, the guy that owns this place, lived in Georgia for like 9 years or 11 years and moved up to New York and opened up like the first barbecue spot in the Lower East Side.
I love barbecue.
He's been here almost 9 years, going on 9 years, and I love it. Yeah. This is a barbecue spot.
This is a real spot.
This is like a pit.
This is the pit.
In the Lower East Side, this is the pit.
So how is it? Low East Side or Low East Siders? Like, I don't know.
It depends where you grew up, on what side of the Lower East Side, you know? If you grew up towards the East Village, what was known as Alphabet City, you're a Low East Sider.
Low East Sider.
But if you lived a little lower down by Grand Street, you lived in the Lower East Side.
Okay.
I grew up in Brooklyn, so I used to just come out here, skate, and hang out here and there.
That's something about the banana pudding, right?
He makes a banana pudding that I don't even know how to describe it. Once it comes out, you'll see the texture and the look and the color of this, and you'll be like, what is this? Is this really banana pudding?
You're such a sneaker genius, right?
I'm ready to
quiz you, all right?
Shoot, let's go.
What year did the Jordan 4s come out?
At 1989.
Okay.
It's just too easy.
Explain to me.
Name another Jordan.
Jordan 6s.
1991. Go again.
How do you know the answer so quick?
It's just
man.
Too easy.
This is exactly what's on the card. It was on the card.
Explain that to me. Come on, Jordan, I don't know.
The first pair of Jordans was 1985.
Okay.
Right? The first pair of Jordans ever to be released. The pair that got him the Chicago Bulls fined $5,000 per game because Michael Jordan was wearing a three-color shoe in the NBA when only two colors were allowed, right? So 1985 was a epic year for footwear, for basketball, for just the beginning of what is now sneaker culture.
All right, now I'm gonna try and stump you on this one question, okay? What size is Michael Jordan?
Size 13. Everybody knows that. He wears the 14 sometimes, but on court, he wears a 13 and a 13 and a half. Because like every guy, you feel like one foot is bigger than the other.
What are you saying?
I say he'll flip you.
He'll what?
Flip you. Flip you for real.
Oh, man.
You
nice.
Ooh,
oh, please.
Wow.
Wow.
What is you've this, never been here. Play? I wanted to hook you up with a real selection of some of the stuff we do.
Oh, man.
Whoa.
This is how. Ooh.
Hold on, Alan. Before you go anywhere, tell me what we got in front of
please
us.
Please explain.
Right.
We'll start with you real quick. That's the fast one. We got some buttermilk fried chicken and some of our homemade coleslaw, which is a little bit different than most places do it. We have a little kick from some sriracha in there. Also, the potato
in the
salad.
Coleslaw?
Yeah.
In sriracha?
Yeah, it's got
wow.
a little bit of a little booster in there. And then over here on the board, we got some of the baby back ribs, some of our oak smoked pulled pork, Samson style wings. Those are grilled wings that are done just with a spice rub.
Whoa.
Awesome. He's obviously got a little bit of coleslaw. And that right there is one of my favorites. That's a andouille sausage. Pork and beef
man.
With some good seasoning. Check it out, guys.
This is awesome.
That's pretty sick. And what's the sauce?
That's our homemade barbecue sauce we do here.
Is it homemade or is it store made?
Yeah, come on, man. You know, you know me well enough.
Oh
yeah.
Man, this is awesome.
It's got some good stuff in there.
Dig
dark
in, she,
dark
oh,
beer,
love this potato
brown
salad.
Sugar.
Oh man.
All right.
We're very good.
All right. Well, enjoy it, fellas.
Well, thank you so much.
Anything else?
Wow, Rashid, look, here comes that banana pudding.
The banana figgy pudding.
Oh man, get out of here. I hope you save room. Because this
did.
Is the big finish.
Oh, I definitely did.
Oh,
thanks,
oh,
Alan.
Let me make some space for you, fellas.
Oh, thanks,
oh,
man.
This is awesome.
Look at it. This is just like.
Are there any secret ingredients in here? Is this grandma's recipe or your recipe?
This is our recipe here. We take vanilla pudding. It's not actually banana flavored pudding because they make that and that stuff's garbage. There's a vanilla pudding where we make some fresh whipped cream, fold it up in there to lighten up the pudding, then layer that with everybody's favorite, the little vanilla wafers, and then some fresh bananas.
Mm.
Everybody loves it.
Oh, this is awesome, Chris. Man, Alan, thank
Cheers,
you
man.
So much. I appreciate
Thanks
everything.
Thanks for coming in, I appreciate it.
Hey, yo, so Chris. Why don't you give us a 10-second shameless plug, man?
Well, I'll give you a banana pudding plug, even better. Huh?
All right, let's go.
Georgia's East Side Barbecue, located at 192 Orchard Street. The best banana pudding in the Lower East Side of New York.
Mm.
My name's Chris Vidal. I work for a New York brand called A-Life, and you can find me at FoodRap on Instagram. That's FoodRap.
FoodRap. Hey, you know what, Alan? You need a 10-second shameless plug. Go for it, man.
All right, I appreciate that. Georgia's East Side Barbecue. We're down here at 192 Orchard Street. 9 years running, going strong. Thanks so much.
Check us out next time on Soul Food Kicks and Giggles. I'm at Rashid Young. Peace.